All right, beautiful people, Honest Am. I'm back to do our weekly, our weekend message. We are entering a full moon in Taurus. Fridays is also a Venus day, and Taurus is ruled by Venus. And so we're getting a lot of Venus energy. And so I felt like it may be a really, really good time to do a little quick love reading. But before we get into the love reading, I do want to let you know that I put some angel cards to just try to see what is this full moon in Taurus bringing us, because the full moon is all about manifestations and things coming to light. And the two cards that I put is peace and synthesis. Now, this card of synthesis is all about a diverse group of people or a diverse group of elements coming together to form something amazing. Right here on this card, we see a rainbow. For me, for some reason, I'm getting this idea that the election may have like really stormed up, like brought up a lot of things and a lot of diverse people mind, that they're no longer wanting to deal with how the way that the world is going. And so a lot of people are about to start coming up and fighting for their peace. A lot of people, I just feel like a lot of good positive energy is coming with this card with peace. And so if you may be feeling just some anxiety or just feeling like, you know, oh my God, is the Antichrist in office? Is the world about to end? No, we will be over before the world is over. And the message that I get very strongly is just to have peace, that everything is coming together. So I hope that no matter where that this message finds you, that that message gives you just a little bit of peace during this turbulent time. And so now, dear God, guardian angels and ancestors, we want to clarify just this message of peace and synthesis. What do you want us to know on this beautiful Friday? What do we need to know? Allow no room for doubt or confusion in me or the mirror's mind. Just one card, God. All right, and we got one card exactly. And the card that came out is the Six of Pentacles. Six of Pentacles is all about, as you can see right here, there is a woman. She has two gifts in her hands. Two people are kind of like begging, or maybe they're like seeing what gift that she would give her. The energy that I am getting is that for some of you guys, there's going to be some blessings coming in. Somebody's going to come in to offer you something. The Six of Pentacles can also speak to things from the past returning again. And honestly, this position can be from both ways. Like, even though she's standing out here giving gifts with those two people also kneeling down there, you could be the person giving a gift or you can be the person receiving a gift. Either way it goes, if you're looking for something, I do feel like it's going to come very soon. At the bottom of the deck, we have, oh my God, we have the Knight of Cups and the Queen of Wands. And so if you've been busting your ass, working very hard, you know, pouring into your endeavors, using that, you know, using your witchy qualities, using the supernatural to help you, you know, rule your kingdom, then somebody's going to come in no matter what. I mean, we got two gifts coming in. Somebody is coming in to bring you something. Somebody's coming in to offer you a cup. And this cup that they are offering, it can either be with, because we had the Pentacles, it could be a job offer that could be coming in for you. And because we have the Cups, it could be also a love offer that is coming in for you. So either way, it's some beautiful energy that's coming in for this full moon in Taurus. All right, dear God, guardian angels and ancestors, clarify this message of synthesis, peace, Queen of Wands, Six of Pentacles, Knight of Cups. What do we need to know about our love life? What is Mama Venus, angel number 333 on the clock, bringing to us in our love life? Allow no room for doubt or confusion in me or the viewer's mind. What do we need to know about our love life? What's coming to us? What do we need to know? In God's name I pray, Ashe. Just one card, please. Unrequited love. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. So if you find yourself throughout this weekend, if there is what you may find is that you may be given a gift. Somebody may really reveal themselves to show you that this love that you guys have is unrequited. And then somebody else may be coming in to offer you something more or something better. Or it could just be this weekend you may have some issues or something that comes up and brings up some, you know, some turbulence within your relationship. I think that turbulence is coming up for you to see that this may not be the end for you. This may not be the person for you. And so God is saying to free yourself. Know that you don't have to stay in a dead-end relationship just because that person wants you. If you have romantic feelings that you want to explore, that you wish to experience, and that your partner is not giving it to you, you, God is saying, release it, let it go, and trust that I will give you what you need. Trust that by releasing this person, you are giving them a gift to find their person, and they are also giving you a gift to find your person. And so this reading is all about not holding on to things, but really having peace with things falling away so that they can perfectly come together in the end. All right. I really was hoping that it was going to be more of a, like a love reading, but that clearly is not the case. This week, God is telling us this full moon in Taurus, some things may be coming up to let us know that it's time to let a relationship go. Hate to hear it, but we have to pay attention to whatever God is giving us. You know, I am never going to be the reader that's going to sugarcoat things for you. I'm never going to be the reader to tell you to, you know, to put yourself in a relationship that is not, you know, equally yoked for you. I live and die by the quote of bell hooks of love is, if there's any abuse, then it's not love. If somebody is emotionally abusing you, verbally abusing you, that is not love, and you need to get on out of that relationship, okay? All right, God, well, give us a oracle card to clarify this message of free yourself, unrequited love, our Six of Pentacles, the Knight of Cups with the Queen of Wands, along with synthesis and peace. God, why is it so important for us to release the love that is no longer for us so that we can get the love that is meant for us? In God's name, I pray. Ashe, angel number 616 on the clock. Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, for a lot of you guys, you just need to let this person go. Like you have to realize that you can't get the person that you want if you're holding on to what you don't want. You know, like how can God bring in this gift and this offering if you are still entertaining something that's not really truly meant for you? A lot of you guys need to just let it release so that you can have this moment of clarity. All right, come on, one card. Let's finish up. I only got a couple more minutes. I really wanted this thing to be 5 minutes long, but we went a little bit longer. Trust your gut feelings. Let your heart guide you to who you are. That is our final message for this weekend, along with going beyond the ego. Okay, guys, you have to really get out of your head. You got to get out of your heart. This person may have checked everything off your list. They may give you leg shaking orgasms and all that good stuff, but do they make your heart feel fulfilled? Deep down inside. And that's the thing. Deep down inside, your gut knows. You already know if this person is truly meant for you or not. Don't keep holding on to something if you know you want to experience more. If you know this person isn't giving it to you, don't keep going back. Let it go so you can get what you truly want. All right, y'all. I'm going to leave you with this final message from our Sufi wisdom deck. And this message is trust your gut feelings. Trust your gut feelings. I'm tired. I am really tired. I don't know why, but I ain't got it today, y'all. I ain't got it. It makes me sad when I ain't got it. But I also feel like we are in this Taurus energy. Taurus is a very slow, it's an earth energy. And so I think like the universe is like, girl, chill out. Trust that I'm taking care of everything. You don't have to work so hard. That was also our message for Wednesday. So if you need that message, go back and check it out. Angel number 808 on the clock. Money's coming. Each person has been made for some specific work. The longing for that work has been put into the hearts. We waste our energy designing and carrying out plans to become what we already are. Rumi. The secret to having a successful life lies in having a combination of love and faith. Love is the power that makes us fearless to move forward. Faith develops perseverance in us. No matter how long it takes us or the number of challenges that come along the path, it takes both love and faith to lead us joyfully to where we're going. This oracle brings grace to make you aware of a universe inside you. Reach for it by seeking experiences that will open your new dimensions of reality to you. Discover what you genuinely care about and make sure you are being true to Discover what you genuinely care about and make sure you are being true to what you find. When you completely focus on what you are doing and are fully immersed in it, you are in a state of flow. Being in flow makes work effortlessly, your creative power increases, and you will be inspired and more motivated within. Oh, dear one, the way is open for you to see what is possible. The love you feel inside your heart is what directs and guides you to where you have been programmed to go. You already hold the map to your treasures. Your heart is already awakened to divine love. By trusting and following it, you are strengthening your capability to make decisions for your life. Soon you will discover your thoughts are seeds that will sprout and grow. You can break out of confinement and limitations and move beyond what others say you cannot do. Your mantra for this week is, I tell myself I can, it is time to turn my big ideas into reality. I have faith in my vision and I believe in myself. So this is your card for your week. Have faith in your vision, believe in yourself, and trust your heart. All right, y'all, that's all the messages I have for you. I am Honest Am. If you're interested in learning more about me or Honestly Sis, please make sure you check out www.honestlysis.com or find us on YouTube and Substack. Talk to you soon. Honest Am out.